Welcome to Arush Coaching Classes. Today's session talks about data modeling and DAC.
So we are going to cover what is the agenda of today's classes, introduction to the data modeling. Basically, why am I talking so much about data modeling? What is it? Okay, so we'll see them. We'll cover the key concepts related to it. I will also introduce to all of you DACs. Okay, so basically what is DACs? Basically, it is, data analysis expressions, okay? Common DAX functions and the practical examples. So are we ready? Shall we begin? Okay, great. So when I talk about introduction to data modeling, what it says, data modeling is the process of creating a data model for the data to be stored in a database. Oh, the definition is too confusing, right? Importance. What is the importance? Ensures the data is structured and relationships are defined for the efficient querying and reporting. Okay, so let me talk about data modeling, because here the definition is too tough. So the first and the most important thing is data modeling is an important part of Power BI. And what it is? It is the process of creating visual representation of your data, and which data I'm going to identify the relationship which exists between different elements. So if I talk about data models, I'm talking about data models. Okay. So what are these data models? As I told you, it is structured representation of data. That is one thing. Please remember, everyone, data model is the foundation of everything in Power BI, you can say, or whatever. So when I talk about data models, what do we do actually? What is the thing? These are the representation of the data, right? Structured. These are models. And what does Microsoft Power BI does? It is basically an interface. And what is this interface for? For building the data models. If you have to build the data models, you need some interface, and that interface is Power BI. Clear? Okay. You see over here, these are the data models. And when you see these, the connecting lines, these actually represents the relationship. I will come back to this. What do you mean by a relationship? How many types of relationship? All those things I will define. But just to give you what is data model, what is data modeling, the structured representation of your data. It is the fundamental, it is the foundation of everything else in data modeling. Plus Power BI is the interface wherein we are going to work on the things. Okay. Now, before I go on in the further things like properties, relationships and all those things, let me tell you one more thing over here that is known as DAX. Okay, what is DAX? DAX is a formula language for creating custom calculation in Power BI. Right? So basically, I am going to analyze the data and generate a new information from the data which is already in your model. Okay, now when I say, or when I talk about this DAX, I will come back to DAX again. The first thing which I'm talking about, model, right? So let me go here, and first of all, I would like to tell you that what is a model view. Basically, model view is that which visually represents all the data tables, all the relationships, all the columns. Okay, You can use these visuals to shape and structure your data. That is known as model view. So model view is the model icon, right? So we have different types of model views. Okay. It's loading the data. It's taking some time. Go to blank report. I think everybody now knows the interface. Now see this first one, the report view, this one. This is actually known as the diagram view, which is known as canvas. So the first model view is diagram view. Okay. Or the canvas, whatever you want to say. Okay. Then let me come back to my Power BI again. Then this is what? This is basically table view. So table view, you all know, right? Whatever things you have. Then you have model view. This is the model view which we are talking about. Here, the third one, this one, model view. And fourth, here I'm going to put the DAX queries. Okay. Plus this, basically this full thing is known as the data pane. It is like common in all the model view, right? So what is this data pane, which has report, table and model view? So that's the data pane. So the next one is diagram view. Then we have the data pane. Then what is the third one? Properties pane. Properties pane. I will come back to this one later. Where will you see the properties? Fourth is the ribbon. Number fourth is ribbon or home ribbon, you can say. Which is your home ribbon? This one. This is your home ribbon, the top line. This is basically the home ribbon. So this is the model view. Model is the icon. Now, when you talk about these things, data modeling, we have the objects or the things in the database. So attributes and relationship. Attributes are the properties. Just now I told you, properties of the entities. And relationships are what? How are they related to each other? Properties is basically the data which you are going to store in your table, right? That is why it was told as properties view. And relationship, as I told you, how you will connect. You need a connecting wire, right? So that's what it is. Then we have, you know, there's a very important concept in data modeling, and that is basically known as schemas. Now, what do you mean by schemas? If you are going to put here different tables or different sheets, how will you arrange them, right? Suppose if I ask you, okay, there are three tables. How will you arrange? These tables. These are three Excel. So first person will say, I'm going to arrange them horizontally. Second person will say, okay, I'm going to arrange them vertically. Third person will say, okay, I'm going to arrange them in the diagonal form. Fourth person will say, okay, one in center and one in front and two at the back. Or fifth person will say, okay, I will make it in the circular format. So basically five people have five different criteria. Okay, so when you want to arrange your data models, it is actually known as schemas. So schemas are what? Like, you cannot arrange anything anyway. You have to arrange it in the logical framework of the tables in a data set. So please remember, these are logical frameworks. Okay, basically it is a blueprint. It's a logical blueprint that defines the structure, organization and the relationship of the tables. That how will you arrange the tables and how will you go. So now let me introduce to you types of schemas. Okay, So the very first one is the, okay, let me make it here only. Okay, chalo. Flat schema. How do you arrange? This is one table, okay, and then your this table is arranged like this, 2 and 3. Okay, so this is like this and this is like this. Is basically what this is, a flat schema. It defines the data structures. It assists with the visualizations. It leads to meaningful insights. So when you are arranging 4 tables, you can do it one way, the logical framework, that is flat schema. The second way, okay, what is the second way to do this? If I can, oh, so erasing will take a lot of time. Let me make a new one again. Save. Okay, come back to this one. Okay, schemas ke types hai. First, as I told you, is a flat schema, which is like this. Okay, this is a flat schema. Second schema style is star schema. Star. So what do you mean by star? You're going to arrange the data tables in the star format like this. Like this. I'm sorry if I'm going little fast because I want to do the hands-on and show it to you. That is why I'm taking, I'm going little fast. Now, how will you arrange this in the star format? Okay, in the star format, what will you do? You will go here, then go here, go here, then go here, then come here, then come here, then come. This, then this, and this. Plus, you have a center table also. This is known as, you know, fact table and dimension table. So, the one which is in the center is a fact table and the dimension, different dimensions of it. Okay. So, there is a lot of things to study, but I'm giving you a brief quickly. So, this is a star schema. Okay. We are arranging the tables in this way. Then we have the third category of the data, which is known as snowflake. How do you put a snowflake? Basically, this is one table, this is one table, this is one table, and this is one table. What will you do? You are going to, this is like a snowflake. You are going to arrange this way. This is snowflake. Right? Like from, so it is like one to many relationships. From one table, it is connected to many. This is one on one. This is one to many. So relationships are how? One to many, many to one, many to many. So this is how the relationship happened. So I taught you three things. What are schemas? How many types of schemas? And how many types of relationships? Okay. So these are the three different types of schemas which are there, right? Now, just to give you a brief, the flat, okay. Now, let me change the color so that you can understand it easily. So this one, the flat schema is the simplest one. Always remember, the flat schema is the simplest one. Why? Because it stores all the data in a single table, The easier, the simpler. Okay. But what is the disadvantage? When you have large data sets, then this becomes unsuitable. Then we come to star schema. So it is more advanced than the flat schema. Okay. And it is basically center based or central based. From the center, we are trying to connect. Okay. But the disadvantage is that it, lacks the flexibility. Why? Because you have to connect it like a star. So you cannot make it flexible. You cannot shift the tables here and there. So that's why the disadvantage is it lacks the flexibility. Okay. What is snowflake? It is actually extension of your star schema. And how do you do? By adding more tables. And when you are adding more tables, basically it represents hierarchy. When you are trying to represent somewhere the hierarchical form, that time the snowflake picture. Okay? All right. Now, the last thing I'll quickly tell you, and then we'll start with our models and working things and so on. Okay? So the last thing which, why I am telling you this last thing, because this is asked, okay, in most of the interviews, interview question actually, cardinality, how the tables in a database are related to each other or related to one another is known as cardinality. And how they are related, one-to-one relationship, then what is one to many relationship, and third one is many to many relationship. This is known as cardinality. Okay, wherein what are we doing? What is the meaning? How the tables in the data set relate to one another. Okay, now one more thing I want to tell you. And that is, granularity. Okay? So what do you mean by it? The level of details in the data set. How much details are you putting across? So when I talk about my star schema, when I'm talking about star schema, it represents what? It represents many to one. Right? Yes. And when I'm talking about my snowflake, I told you it's going to represent the hierarchical form. So always remember, when it is one to one, it's a flat schema. When it is many to one, it's a star schema. When it is hierarchical form, it is snowflake. These are important questions when you go for the interviews. Cardinality, granularity, how the data models are arranged, you have to identify. All these things you can, you know, if you know, you can crack the interviews. In case you want to learn in detail, please go through it and then we will explore further on this. All right. So without putting in a lot of time, I actually want to take you to the hands-on activity. So just give me 2 more minutes and then we'll go over there. So I think now you have understood what do I mean by star schema, the central fact table connected to the dimension table. Okay. So whenever a table is in the center, it is a fact table and we have different dimensions. Like suppose there's a house. So that's the basic, the fact table. And what all dimensions we have? We have the floor area, the plinth, the terrace area. You have, you know, the bedroom. So different dimensions of it like that. Snowflake, as I told you, it is more complex and with the normalized dimensions. Normalization means process to reduce the data redundancy and improve data integrity. So obviously, these are more theoretical questions. So please go through it since we have less time. So I'm just going further in this. Okay. Now, as I told you, DAX is basically data analysis expression. Like in Excel, you use formulas, right? So we have different formulas. Min, max, all, count, max, filter, this, that. And there is a particular syntax which we follow. Okay. So what is that syntax? The syntax is first you have to write the column name. Any column name you can write. Basically, it's like a variable name. This is my first thing. Second is equal to. Equal to represent that I am going to start my formula from here. Okay. And then you write the DAX expression. How do you write a DAX expression? It is divided into 2 sections, 3 and 4. 3 is basically like sum, count, average, whatever. It is always in the capital format. And fourth is what? You have to give the table name plus the column name. Table name and column name. So this is the syntax. So basically, if you see here, this is what? This is a variable, point number one. Equal to is the assignment. This is the formula. The third one is the formula or the function, whatever we will use. This is my table name. This is my table name. And this is what it is. It is table column. This is the syntax of DAX function. Clear? Okay. Now moving on further from here, if you see aggregate function, sum, average, min, max, count. Okay. So whenever you are doing aggregation, aggregation is you are trying to sum it off. Maybe average, minimum, max, count. Some mathematical calculations you are doing, right? Logical is if and or not, right? Text functions, as I told you, when you have to concatenate left, you have to trim it left, right, mid, all those things you can do. Date functions, as I told you, when you have to, you know, represent your data monthly, yearly, seasonal, day wise, whatever, quarter wise, so many things. So these are the common DAX functions. Then we have the advanced calculations or advanced functions. So calculate means it modifies the context in which the data is evaluated. See, there we were doing the summation. Here we are giving the calculation of it, and then like filtering. Again, it will be like a subset. Like I talked about the snowflake data, snowflake schema. So there, this filter things, when you create subsets of a table, when you create hierarchy, it comes like this. Related, it returns a related value. All, it ignores all the filters. Okay?